Hi, I'm Mark from Sounds and Sync, the developer of EdiCue. In this video, I'm going to show you what's new in EdiCue version 4. The first of two main updates we've added is to allow EdiCue to read and write Pro Tools session files. This allows you to drag and drop a PTX file onto the main window to import the ADRQ data from either the audio clips, clip groups, or both. If all of the cue tracks, including the prod info and scene numbers tracks, contains clip groups, you can then select to load the clip data from clip groups only. This will speed up the load time as EdiCue can then ignore all the audio clips in the session. An alternative way to load the data from a session file is to click the Get Session Toolbar button or press Command-G on macOS or Control-G on Windows. This will load the cue data from the session file that is currently open in Pro Tools. Just make sure you save any changes in Pro Tools before loading. On the export side, EdiCue can now export a Pro Tools session containing clip groups. It also now has the ability to set the color of the exported clip group from the text in the clip name. By default, all clip groups containing a to-be-written cue are exported in red. While creating a template Pro Tools cue session, you can now load a PDF shooting script to extract the character names while setting up the characters for the production. Once the template is complete, it can now also be exported as a PTX file. The second main update for EdiCue version 4 is the integration with Nuendo 12. From the EdiCue Preferences window, select Nuendo in the door list. EdiCue communicates with Nuendo using a network protocol, so both applications can either run on the same computer or on different computers on the local network. EdiCue uses these three marker tracks containing cycle markers to store the cue data. The ADR cues track contains the ADR cues for all actors. A new project interface window has been added to EdiCue to set the properties of Nuendo cycle markers while creating cues. Like the session interface window, a PDF shooting script can be loaded to extract the character lines from the script. Once the cues are complete, EdiCue can import the data for all cues directly from Nuendo into the main window by clicking the Get Project button. EdiCue can then export its files in the same way as when the data is loaded from Pro Tools or any other file type. If, for example, you need to load the cue data from an EdiCue PDF into Nuendo, simply drop the PDF onto the EdiCue main window and load this data into new marker tracks in Nuendo by selecting the menu item File, Send Data to Nuendo Project. Nuendo is now ready to record these ADR cues using the cycle markers in the ADR cues track. Another new feature of EdiCue version 4 is the Compare ADR Cue Lists window. This window allows you to load two EdiCue cue sheet PDFs so it can check the revisions made between two exports. Looking at the exported report, you can make sure that all new cues required are listed, that all new cues have been assigned to the correct character, and if a reconfirm was performed between the two exports, you can check that it hasn't removed any Pro Tools clips or Nuendo markers that are still required. While loading either a Pro Tools PTX file or text file, a new option has been provided to ignore clips on inactive tracks. In addition, mute clips are now loaded all the time, and their state is now shown in the last column of the cue list window. Mute or inactive cues are only exported in a PTX file as a mute clip. This provides a way of hiding cues from the exported PDFs and other file types, but by including them in the exported PTX file, they are retained when a cue session is regenerated. To try EdiCue 4 out for yourself, either on macOS or Windows, just head to the download page of the website. Once the app is installed, just run it and click Try to activate a trial license.